This is the SAP Developer News for December 12, 2024.
Hola, SAP developers. We're here at the UK ISOC Connect in Birmingham, where we've been here with our developer advocates in the SAP TechEd stand, running the developer garage, and with our colleagues in the Ask the Experts booth.
And we've met a ton of people who have come to do tutorials. We've given some sessions. So I've given a session about SAP Build Code and SAP Build Apps with DJ. And through the floor, we've met a lot of people who follow what we're doing, and it's been very exciting.
And we've had some great conversations. In fact, this is the ideal combination of hands-on keyboards and talking to each other face-to-face and learning from each other and reconnecting with each other. I've got to rush off now because I'm going to deliver another session, a hands-on session on Terraform Provider for SAP BTP. So it's goodbye from me.
And from me.
And me. See you later.
Bye-bye.
The November 2024 edition of SAP BTP InnoBytes is out now with more fresh, snackable insights on BTP. This time, there's information on planning integration between SAP Analytics Cloud and SAP Datasphere. There's information on a new starter edition of SAP Integration Suite, and on the document information extraction area, there's a new premium edition. Information on that is in this month's InnoBytes. Check the video out. It's only 4 minutes long. Link, as always, in the description.
Hello, everyone. November release of Capaya 2024 is now available. So many things have happened since the first release of Getting Started and Cookbook Guides. Many of them needed major updates and overhaul. Hence, Capaya now has revised Getting Started guides and also an overview of key concepts. Welcome page, Getting Started index pages, Introduction, What is CAP, Best Practices, and Anti-Patterns are some of the revised content. Learn More page combines information which was earlier spread across several pages. There is a new guide for aspect-oriented modeling and improved CDR definition language reference. Coming to the CDS language and compiler topics, we have updates about the new CDL parser with significant size reduction and planned rollout in three phases. Now there is support for open intervals with @assert.range by wrapping the min and the max values in parentheses. Node.js updates include a new plugin for RFC. CDS-RFC now enables importing RFC-enabled function modules from SAP S/4HANA system. New CDS-i18n API can be used consistently for both serving localized SAP Fiori UIs as well as for localized messages at runtime. The default fuzziness threshold used by CAP Node.js is 0.7 and is now made configurable. Besides this, @search.fuzziness threshold and @search.ranking annotation is now supported by the CAP Node.js runtime. The new CLI command CDS debug lets you easily debug local or remote Node.js applications in Chrome DevTools. You can now also have automatic handler stubs in Node.js projects for both JavaScript and TypeScript with the command CDS add handler. Finally, in CAP Node.js, you can now create ECMAScript module projects with CDS add ESM command. For CAP Java, simpler recursive hierarchies can be realized with @aggregation.recursive_hierarchies annotation. You can now filter and sort by sub-elements of CDS.map elements in CAP Java. Enhanced instance-based authorization is supported in CAP Java with introduction of a new configuration option, reject-selected-unauthorized-entity. Last update is about MTX. In June release of Capaya, it was announced that only few annotations are allowed as extensions. You can now add exceptions for these restrictions, but at your own risk, using the annotations property. Please visit the Capaya documentation for further details. You can find the link to the documentation in the description.
You probably know that SAP Workflow Management and SAP Intelligent RPA have been retired to be replaced by SAP Business Process Automation. Now, you would have to do some migration. And recently, there have been some migration webinars to help you along the way. In Lou Jane's blog post, there are also some resources listed that can support you in this migration. And coming soon to this blog post will be the addition of links to these migration webinar replays in case you missed them. So check out Lou Jane's blog post and happy migrating.
We'd like to point your attention to recent blog posts by Marion Zeiss that covers the topic of SAP B2B authentication, but in the context of pipelines. He talks about how in automated pipelines can also be often be difficult to handle authentication mechanisms securely and simply. And he offers an approach using the SAP Passport instead of certificate-based authentication and using the Playwright module to simplify the processing of the passport. He does a really good job of describing the overall details of this solution, some code samples of how to set up the context with the certificate, and how to use the Playwright client certificate login package. Even has links to the GitHub repos and the package authentication, the package details, as well as a code sample from his own GitHub repository on how to set up and use the scenario that he is describing. So this is a challenge that you face. We think you should definitely check out his blog post and see how he has solved the solution for himself and shared the solution with the community.